if you introspect and look back, that in January I had made you all aware that there are going to be subtle changes. So in the month of July, I'm actually reminding you all once again, if you all haven't made the changes, please make the changes. But these changes can only be made if you are deliberate and you are prepared with an open mind to recalibrate yourself, to redetermine yourself and to re-strategize and probably look into the pattern of your life. And if the changes are to be made, you can make them both personally and professionally. And a gentle reminder that whatever changes you make now, once the Jupiter goes direct in August and Saturn goes direct in September, you will actually see the benefits and you will actually see that how rewarding these changes can be. To add on again, I would say a little contemplation. In July, there are two major eclipses coming in. And there is also the retrograde of Mercury, which actually is advising you that now is the time to contemplate, to introspect, rather than hone your communication skills. So you don't have to be angry, you don't have to be aggressive, you don't have to give it back immediately because your tongue is going to tickle quite a bit. So controlling your tongue, controlling your communications is going to be very, very rewarding. And the best way, rather than feeling stressed out that, oh my God, I, because of the eclipses or because of the Mercury retrograde, I have to again control myself. My answer to you would, no, you don't have to control yourself. You just need to go inward, and probably meditation is the best outlet because it will not only make you mentally stronger, but it will also help you know what is the shape that you want to give to your life for the next couple of years. Libra, the month of July 2019 for you. Well, this month there is support from a distance. The Sun, Neptune, Mars and Saturn are all helping you from their positions around the zodiac. You may have some very good insights because Neptune is very well positioned. Basically, go slowly and be positive. Things will work out just fine. Awakened Libras like to keep life in balance. This month, be mindful, positive and helpful. Qualities that are easy for you. In regards for the monthly overview, your creativity is one of your major gifts and you should remind yourself to put it to use by the end of the month. After all, you can definitely visualize a way out of this quagmire at work or at home. And you might be surprised to realize that nobody else can do it better than the way you do. And that will be very real, and you will be very really grateful for your own input into your work. Some radically wonderful days come your way. In fact, you may never be quite the same again, and that's definitely very good. You need to make sure that you're giving yourself enough time to rest and recuperate after all the excitement, or your batteries could be running low. If they are running low, take a nap or go to get a 20-minute massage, or doing yoga nidra can help you. Focus on your relationships and how happy you are with them. Knowing is better than being in the dark. Meet up with the friends and do something that's just plain fun. In fact, I would say calibrate and focus and concentrate on how good your relationships are, or whether they require mending, or whether they require strengthening, or maybe you require to look into what your partner needs. In regards to your love and relationships, there's no problem you can't use your creativity to solve, and that includes your romantic problems. So if you encounter a setback, use your extraordinary gifts to sort things out. You, who wants to see a stupid movie when you could go for a walk in the rain anyway? You will experience some pretty wonderful feelings when you are together, and this could be a start of something wonderful. So what I mean to say is, go for togetherness. Don't thrust your wants or desires or likes or what you want to do. Doing things what both want to do is what is going to strengthen the relationship. Don't forget to do what you need to do, and that is to take care of yourself physically, mentally and emotionally. After all, feeling burnt out is no way to go about getting a love affair off the ground. Question your relationships, even if it seems like a hard thing to do. Be there completely, no matter what is happening. In regards to your career, if you don't get a raise, you should at least get a great big congratulatory note from all your co-workers, and great news is soon going to follow. Be sure to get enough rest, focus some of your energy on how well your work relationships are working. This month is all about teamwork, networking and getting along well with your bosses and co-workers alike. In regards to your health and fitness, how are your hamstrings, your hip joints, how are your ankles, your lower back, how's your neck, how about your triceps? You'd do best to really focus on what it is that needs more and love and attention in your physical self. So listen to your body. You must hit your strides in fitness and feeling good-wise, not to mention your efforts to be honest and true to yourself, while still kind in your interactions with others. Pat yourself on the back. You are doing a great job if you're doing it for your physical well-being. For the best days, for your career days, for your honey days, for your money days, and for your love and romantic days, you definitely have to visit my website. Now, this year has been very, very significant because of so many retrogrades and so many shadowy planets that have been hovering around our chart. So it's very important for you all to revert back to your natal charts, to actually see what talents you were born with, what was your destiny, and how you can re-strategize, recalibrate and redetermine your goals and your ambitions in life. So this year is like a change which can be definite, a change which can be better for you guys, but only the awareness and then getting the change is going to be beneficial. But if you're just going to expect changes to happen in your life, then chances are those changes may actually not be good. So please be aware of your natal chart. Please go through your natal charts, and you need to know what is the pattern of your life, what is the pattern that the life is taking, and do you need to change those patterns in your life, because eventually life is what you make it. So the thoughts that you have in your mind are the ones that are going to be put into action, and action is what will determine your fate. So changing your fate, shaping your destiny through the talents, by knowing it through your natal chart, will do you a world of good.